Welcome to DIYTryin.
Attach sensors to all the things.
I'm Patrick Norton.
I'm Michael Hand.
This man is the hero of our office today.
That's what we're gonna do today. We're gonna make you into the office hero.
Sensors, Raspberry Pi, website.
Yeah.
Hundreds of people hours saved.
So here at DDN, we have a big bathroom problem where there's two bathrooms.
Yeah. And like 54 people.
Yeah. So there's a lot of waiting in line for the bathroom. So I made it so that I made a website using a Raspberry Pi to update and tell you whether or not the bathroom is actually open.
So, you know, you could, if you want to, use the Raspberry Pi B Plus, the recent update to the Raspberry Pi model. We did a review of that on Tekzilla, youtube.com/Tekzilla, I guess last week, 2 weeks ago when it came out.
Like that.
It's very similar. Watch the video to find out how similar it actually is. But right now, you're actually basically using a door sensor, a homemade door sensor, feeding in information to the Raspberry Pi, which sends a signal out to a web server.
Using Dropbox for that, because I'm cheap.
I like being cheap. And the final piece de resistance, which is disconnected at the moment so I don't electrocute myself, signal lights.
Yeah, so we have signal lights so that if people don't want to go to the website, they can just check that out.
Should we start with the sensor, the code, or the website?
Let's just do it all right after, one after another.
Sensors.
Sensors it is. Here are my ghetto aluminum foil and duct tape with some wire sensors. So, pretty simple. There's one sensor on the inner door jamb and then one on the door over here. So when the door closes, it'll close the contact and then the Raspberry Pi knows that the button is closed. All right, our door sensor wires are running to this breadboard, which we have it wired up with some resistors so that the Raspberry Pi knows when the connection is closed and which door the connection is closed on. So from there, we can see that, and then we can modify some HTML in our update page, and then send that up to Dropbox, because that's what we're using as our hosting. So also connected here is we have an 8-channel relay, but we're only using 2 channels of it. This is used so that when the door connection is closed, it'll turn on a light so that if people don't want to go to the website, they can just check to see if the light's on. Because if it's on, someone's in the bathroom.
Michael and I got back from the local building recycling center with a couple of 8.5-inch stoplight lenses and a big old length of heavy-duty extension cord that I basically connected all of the neutral lines from the 2 lamps and from the pigtail we needed for the power supply. And since we were in a pretty simple kind of scroungy mood on this project, we got out the Gorilla tape and used that to tape our stoplight lenses to the front of our lamps.
On to the actual code. First, we have all of our libraries that we're importing. The important ones here are Beautiful Soup, which makes it really easy to modify HTML, and rpi.gpio, that makes it so you can access the GPIO pins on the Raspberry Pi. Then we set up our GPIO pins. I'll put a link in the show notes of what you need for the Raspberry Pi. It's a little bit different than an Arduino. You just need a resistor, pretty much. We have our input pins that are connected to the doors and our output pins, which trigger the lights. We got some generic variables here, and then the HTML file that we'll be actually updating, and onto our first function. Some cool things, the threading.timer function will let you just keep on running a function, so that's how it'll run indefinitely. Getting access to our count variables so that we can check how long someone's been in there. Not as creepy as it sounds, it's just so that after 10 minutes, if the door has been closed, I'll post a status saying, hey, the door might just be closed and no one's in there, so check it out. Then on to actually checking to see if our connections are closed. So if it is closed, we'll send the status 1 and the bathroom number to our update HTML function. Show that in a minute. We'll update the timer and then we'll turn on the light. Otherwise, we'll send status 0, we'll reset the count timer, and then we'll turn the light off. And then if the count has been over 600 seconds, we'll send status 3 in the bathroom. Same idea for bathroom 2. So our update HTML function, it'll accept the bathroom number that's being sent and the status number. First, we open up our HTML file. If the bathroom is closed, then it'll modify the divs and all that. Beautiful Soup makes things so easy. If the bathroom is open, then we'll say it's open. And if the bathroom's been closed for a long time, we'll say jiggle the handle. Then we need to update the website. Right now I'm using a script called Dropbox Uploader that just uploads files to Dropbox. Then I'm sending it to the public folder so that I can do a generic URL forwarding from the website that I bought. And then the end of the function is just to set off the initial function so that the timers can kick in. And that's about it. And from all of that, we can go to our bathroomstatus.com and refresh. I should probably put an auto refresh, but you can see that bathroom one is now closed as of this time, and bathroom two is open at this point. And of course, our lights also signal that information. And if you want to learn more about Python or the Raspberry Pi, you can check out our sponsor, lynda.com/DIY. They've got tons of Python tutorials up and running with the Raspberry Pi. Lots of good information. You'll learn something and you'll help out the show. lynda.com/DIY. Hey, Trace, what do you think of bathroomstatus.com?
I think it's awesome. I even put it on my dashboard.
Currently, bathroom one is closed, sadly. Oh,
no. Hey, Trace, did you notice the new addition?
What new addition?
Look over there.
Oh, my God.
You got some lights.
Wow, that's a really massive light.
Okay, bathroom one is open, bathroom two is open. I'm gonna pee.
It works! It's open. See you around.
People are so into this project. I've had like 10 people come up to me and be like, this is the best thing I've ever seen.
It's because people hate waiting for the bathroom because they could be finishing a script or calling somebody to set up an interview or ordering something on Amazon or ordering cannoli or rearranging their pencils or doing anything but sitting in line and waiting for the bathroom. The thing is though, while we used, you know, Sensor plus Raspberry Pi plus Python to create a device that tells people when the bathroom is open or not open, you could use this to say with a thermal sensor to tell you, send you a message when your freezer is getting above 32 degrees, mm-hmm. or if there's water in the basement of your house.
You could use Beagle boards, Arduinos, anything that you want. It just depends on how much money you want to spend, whether you need networking, and what you like to code in.
What do you like to code in? Do us a favor, tell us, DIYTryin@revision3.com or @DIYTryin, and do us a favor, share the show with your friends, tell them to subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, you should subscribe. Find out all about it on our new website, DIYTryin.com.
It's slick.
It's awesome. It's shiny, and there's buttons that help you share and get the RSS feeds or however you want to watch us. We're on the Roku, we're on iTunes, we're everywhere, man.
And of course, we're on YouTube.com/DIYTryin, but go to the new website, because it's nice.
It's nice. I'm Patrick Norton.
I'm Michael Hand.
We'll see you next week on DIYTryin. Making lives great. That's it for this episode of DIYTryin. We're gonna quit while we're ahead. This is our last episode.
Sorry.
Yeah. It was we need a shot of that face. We were joking, but we need a shot of that face. That was awesome.